T-minus 3 minutes and counting. We've completed our communications checks for the Apollo 8 astronauts in the cabin, and the communications are go.
We verify the
during this period, once we do get the firing command, the various tanks within the three stages of the Saturn V launch vehicle begin to pressurize. We have firing command. The firing command is in. We're now on the automatic sequence. T-minus 2 minutes, 20 seconds. Status board indicates that all aspects are ready. Instrument unit is ready. Spacecraft ready. Final check of emergency detection system. That relay light has gone out. First stage preparations are completed.
All systems ready. Okay.
Ready to go to Conway.
And by water.
Okay, you're on.
All systems go.
T-minus 45 seconds and counting. First stage of the oxygen tank has been pressurized and the process is still building up. Coming up in 90 seconds, mark T-minus 90 seconds and coming. The Apollo 8 crew standing by, spacecraft commander Frank Warner, General Bill Andrews. Now we report that the liquid hydrogen tank in the third stage is pressurized. 1 minute 15 seconds. Propellants pressurized at this time as we come up on the 60-second mark on the flight to the moon. T-minus 60 seconds and counting, the vehicle now is completely pressurized. We're coming up on a power transfer shortly. We have the power transfer. We're now on the flight batteries within the launch vehicle. Final reports from Frank Borman at this time. Final look at the source list of work of the spacecraft. 20 seconds. All aspects we are still in the world at this time.
I'm Jim Lovell, and I was one of the crew of this spacecraft, Apollo 8. We were the first men to see the surface of the moon from just a few miles away. But it was the hundreds of thousands of men and women who worked on that team, and the millions of people who supported the mission that really made it possible. That way, I guess, we all went to the moon. Now, on the other side of those doors, you'll find an actual Saturn V moon model. It's still the most powerful, the most complex machine ever built.